Non-human animals. How complex are their communication systems? Well, listen in on this critter. Spot the difference? After one paper claimed this monkey is taking a base word and adding a grammatical suffix, I was stunned. I fell down a rabbit hole and into some nests, burrows, hives, dens. I animate tales about languages, human languages, but I had to know, are animals really out there stringing together meaningful words or even sentences? Can other animals grammar? If you've been watching my animations, you know I'm fascinated by human communication. But years ago, my wandering interests led me to create two short videos about other species' signals. The first one compared animal communication versus language, using Hockett's so-called design features. The second introduced us to the amazing bee waggle dance. I didn't intend to stop there, immediately wanted to make more, but always felt I'd need to find my footing in the literature first. Fast forward to when I ran into this paper about how Campbell's monkeys add a suffix to their calls. I immediately had to know more. I asked patrons, animal grammars? Eventually they said yes. So I read, and read, and read. I followed the trail down into 104 sources, papers, articles, a few books. Realizing I couldn't hold it all in my head anymore, I made a spreadsheet called Grammanimals. It's a table of the species, groups, and individuals I was meeting along the way, their systems and arguably grammatical backstories. They're all lovely and amazing. Primates, birds, cetaceans, lizards, insects, cephalopods, seemingly everyone's out there sequencing their signals with some kind of conspicuous syntax. Today, I reemerge to drag you into the depths of this with me. That a squid metaphor? Now, you don't need to be all into animals for this to hold your attention. You don't have to be someone who frees mouse feet from glue traps or moves bugs to safety. Ew. Okay, let's not point fingers. Nobody's weird here. You don't need any of that to be intrigued by these grammanimals. Here's what you're in for. A series walking through the grammaring animals in several parts. We'll start with teaching non-human animals to grammar and how that kind of fell apart. Then learning from them, studying their wild grammars. Once all parts launch, I'll stitch together the whole animation in one long special feature. My first count puts it all at over 56 minutes. I'll be curious how long it turns out once all is cut and done. Along the way, we'll meet most of the grammanimals. With them in mind, I played around a lot with art concepts until I came up with these kind of critter profile sheets and this decorated grammanimals journal. I want to craft the look and feel of this project around animating animals in these pages and in this book. Before we talk specifics, a crucial note about fields of study and terminology. As their blend of a name implies, grammanimals are going to ask us to combine concepts both animal and grammatical. They bottle up tensions that pull open a strange space I'm asking us to sink into, getting cozy in a nexus somewhere between linguistics and animal communication. Animal linguistics is a big story of complex calls and signals. Along the way, I'll avoid theory-heavy sections, but despite my best efforts, we do need some jargon. So pay attention for two things. One, coming from linguistics, we'll take a tip from this paper and risk using terms like syllable, word, sentence when talking about non-human animal systems. Sometimes with scrutiny, often not. Please understand these as provisional parallels that enable comparisons, not proven certainties. Less, it's a sentence. More, is this sentence-like? Two, going the other way, we'll take terms from biology, ethology, the many disciplinaryologies that feel like they have something to say about animal communication. These include the basics like species or signals, but also terms that really give you a taste of the literature, from conspecifics to penguin syrinxes to ASOs. Bonus, we can use these to watch out for what animal signals might teach us about human language. Sometimes there are mismatches or unevenness, like the term displacement is important within this interface and somewhat in animal communication generally, but I rarely read it in linguistics. Sometimes terms obviously come from two opposing places, talking past each other. Here's a classic: morphology means two very different things, whether you're the kind of person who focuses on the gram or the animal. I'll keep a running list of terms in my sources document below, alongside my usual source citing for every claim I make. Enough background. I'm ready to get into this. I'm already animating part 2, where our story begins with attempts to teach animals to speak, to sign, and to button press human words and put them together using human grammar. Next time. Before we part today, instead of an ad, I want to point us to groups who could use our support. They represent animals, their habitats, and people living in and caring for biodiverse areas. You're also welcome to join those who fund my animations, both the ongoing patrons and the one-time tippers. Links below, along with my sources document and spreadsheet. Spoiler warnings for the series, though. Above all, stick around and subscribe for more about our world full of languages and animals.